ESO has just released a stunning new image of a field of stars towards the constellation of Carina. This striking view is ablaze with a flurry of stars of all colors and brightness, some of which glow against a backdrop of gas and dust clouds. A complex nebula created by previous violent ejections surrounds an unusual star in the middle of this field. Astronomers have discovered that this star has a companion. Interactions in this double star system, surrounded by a dusty disk, may be the engine fueling the star's remarkable nebula. Today we will explore a new, beautiful ESO image that shows a rich field of stars centered on a star called HD 87643. A study using a new set of observations has provided astronomers with the best ever views of this exotic type of star. The image, taken in the direction of the constellation of Carina, shows a dense starscape towards the Carina arm of the Milky Way galaxy. As we come closer, we see the star HD 87643, a so-called BE star at a distance of 4,900 light-years. The image beautifully shows the extended nebula of gas and dust that reflects the light from the star. The central star's wind appears to have shaped the nebula, leaving bright, ragged tendrils of gas and dust. A careful investigation of these features seems to indicate that there are regular ejections of matter from the star, every 15 to 50 years. The sheer range of the set of observations, from the panoramic wide-field imager shot to the fine details of the VLTI observations, corresponds to a zoom-in factor of 60,000 between the two extremes. With this data, the astronomers found out that HD 87643 has a companion star located at about 50 times the Earth-Sun distance and is embedded in a compact dust shell. The two stars probably orbit each other in a period between 20 and 50 years. The presence of this companion could provide an explanation for the regular ejection of matter from HD 87643 that forms its amazing nebula. As the companion star moves in a highly elliptical or oval-shaped orbit, it regularly comes very close to HD 87643 and triggers an ejection of stellar material. This celestial tango may be what generates the gorgeous nebula.
The NASA ESA Hubble Space Telescope has recently revealed magnificent sections of the Veil Nebula, the shattered remains of a supernova that exploded some 5 to 10,000 years ago. The new Hubble images provide beautiful views of the delicate, wispy structure resulting from this cosmic cataclysm.
Welcome to the Hubblecast. Today, we will take a closer look at one of the most violent events in the universe, a supernova explosion. It is the debris from one of these cosmic explosions that we can see with unprecedented detail in these brand new images from the Hubble Space Telescope. Although we don't usually think about it, the stars twinkling in the night sky do not shine forever. How long a star lives depends on how big and heavy it is. The bigger a star, the shorter its life. Now, a star shines because of the nuclear fire burning at its center. And when a star significantly larger than our Sun runs out of fuel for this fire, it first collapses and then blows itself apart in a gigantic explosion that we call a supernova. A supernova releases so much light that it can outshine all of the stars of an entire galaxy put together. The explosion sweeps out a huge bubble in its surroundings, and at the fringe of this bubble, we find the actual debris from the star, as well as the material that has been swept up by the blast wave. It is this glowing, brightly colored shell of gas that we see as a nebula, and that astronomers refer to as a supernova remnant. Now, the remnant can remain visible for a very long time after the actual explosion itself has faded away.
Astronomers have pointed Hubble towards the constellation of Cygnus to observe the Veil Nebula in the wing of the Swan. Located at a distance of 1,500 light-years from Earth, the Veil Nebula, which is also known as Cygnus Loop, is one of the most spectacular supernova remnants in the sky. The entire shell spans some 3 degrees, corresponding to about 6 full moons. One of the most remarkable parts of the remnant is the so-called Witch's Broom Nebula. The bright blue star, dubbed 52 Cygni, is unrelated to the supernova explosion. It can be observed with the naked eye on a clear summer's night. The small regions captured in the new Hubble images provide stunning close-ups of the Veil. Fascinating smoke-like wisps of gas are all that remain visible of what was once a Milky Way star.
Scientists estimate that the supernova explosion occurred some 5,000 to 10,000 years ago. Now, what that means is that it could have been witnessed and recorded by ancient civilizations. What they would have seen is a star increasing its brightness roughly to the brightness of the crescent moon.
The intertwined rope-like filaments of gas in the Veil Nebula result from the enormous energy released as the fast-moving debris from the supernova explosion plows into the surroundings and creates a shock front. This shock, driven by debris moving at 600,000 kilometers per hour, heats the gas to millions of degrees. It is the subsequent cooling of this material that produces the brilliantly colored glows. The Hubble images of the Veil Nebula are striking examples of how processes that take place hundreds of light years away can sometimes resemble effects we see around us in our daily lives. There are similarities with the patterns formed by the interplay of light and shadow on the bottom of a swimming pool, rising smoke, or wispy cirrus clouds.
So why are astronomers interested in studying supernovae and their remnants? The reason is that they are extremely important for understanding the history of our own Milky Way. Although only a few stars per century in our galaxy end their lives in this spectacular way, these explosions are more or less directly responsible for creating all the elements in our universe that are heavier than iron. For example, all the copper, mercury, gold, iodine, and lead that we see on Earth around us here today were forged in these violent explosions billions of years ago. The expanding shells of the supernova remnants eventually mixed with other material in the Milky Way, and this became the raw material for the next generation of stars and planets, including our own solar system. So the chemical elements that constitute the planets, the Earth, the plants and animals around us, and indeed our very cells, were built deep inside ancient stars and in supernova explosions. So the green in the grass and the red of our blood are in fact the colors of stardust.
In an unprecedented 16-year-long study using several of ESO's flagship telescopes, astronomers have produced the most detailed view ever of the surroundings of the monster lurking at our galaxy's heart, a supermassive black hole. The research has unraveled the hidden secrets of this tumultuous region by mapping the orbits of almost 30 stars.
A team of German astronomers with characteristic precision and patience have spent 16 years mapping out the motions of 28 stars orbiting the very center of our Milky Way galaxy. Now, astronomers have believed for quite a while that the center of our galaxy is the site of a supermassive black hole. Black holes are a consequence of general relativity. They are objects that are so dense and whose gravity is so strong that not even light can escape them. These observations that we're going to show you today are the best evidence yet that black holes are not just theoretical constructs, but actually do exist in reality. This is truly a milestone result.
Observers under dark skies, far from the bright city lights, can marvel at the splendor of the Milky Way arching in an imposing band across the sky. Zooming in towards the center of our galaxy, about 25,000 light years away, you can see that it is composed of myriads of stars. This is a pretty impressive sight, but much is hidden from view by interstellar dust, and astronomers need to look using a different wavelength, the infrared, that can penetrate the dust clouds. With large telescopes, astronomers can then see in detail the swarm of stars circling the supermassive black hole, in the same way that the Earth orbits the Sun. The galactic center harbors the closest supermassive black hole known, and the one that is also the largest in terms of its angular diameter on the sky, making it the best choice for a detailed study of black holes.
So what this team did was that at various points of the past 16 years, they kept taking images of the very central region of the Milky Way. Now from these images, they were able to map out the motions of a total of 28 stars. Now what these motions showed was that these stars aren't just moving about randomly, but that they are clearly orbiting a very massive central object. And the point is that this central object is completely unseen. Now, from the motions, it's also possible to deduce the mass of the central object. It came out to be a little over 4 million times the mass of the Sun. Now, what's more, that enormous mass has to fit into a tiny little volume, and so one cannot escape the conclusion that the central object really is a black hole.
We'll be right back.